Hi guys, welcome back home. It's home to where the heart is, where Jesus is Lord and the word of God is hiding in it. I just did If you're new, and if you've been here, shout out to you. Don't mind my nails and my fingers, and like I just used water, so of course I'm dry and ashy. It's all that. And Kieran said, we'll talk like a pregnant. My brother's with me in the kitchen. Like, if I sound awkward, forgive me. Okay, anyway, guys. But let me talk about my whole experience of being pregnant, right? First of all, I was very judging myself during that period, mainly because
love woman
kafika okay sharp
yay
okay niki jaja mainly because like niki lu woman of God, so niki puta like lina niki re Pamela why ole pregnant niki koloza understand, and then like, and I did that for the longest time. I think he judged you for like a good 6 months. Do you understand? And that is not healthy. But like I did judge myself. And I like, shame. Guys, I won't lie. The support I had, shout out to God. I will give glory to God because, wow. Had I not had that support, I think I would have committed like suicide, look here, because I had so much pressure that like never mind people and how they see me and how a lot of people had put me on this pedestal, yare, I don't even date, and like wow, what, you know, like, you understand? And I didn't live up to those standards that I had set for myself. So like, Niki judge, man. You understand? For like a good 6 months, okay? That the first 3 months, I still went to church and like, I was still very like out there, still seeing people and whatever. But like, after like 3 months, I said, bye streets. And I left the streets. And it, like, I mean, when I was forced to be in town and whatever, like, I'd be in town. But, like, I hated everyone's reaction when they saw me. I hated it because people couldn't pretend to not be disappointed. Like, even if they were pretending to be happy for me, I could see it in their face that they're so disappointed. And I had to thug it out. Okay. So, that was my entire experience for, like, good 6 months. But I still went out anyway. Ah, nani ke cheka, ke di date le motho ka. She motho ka was there for me. And I'll say this, guys, like, do not ever date someone that is not ready, especially like when it comes to what my brother is looking at me, and I want to be honest with you guys. Do not ever date thinking? You are looking at me sharp. Do not ever date someone and have sex with them flesh when they're not ready to have a baby. Because just in case a mistake happens and you fall pregnant and they're not ready, be prepared for a miserable pregnancy. And that is what a lot of people went through. Guys, it was as bad as it was and my man was still present. Imagine if he was not present. I don't want to lie. Because like, pregnancy is so hard, and like, you're going through all these changes alone. Like, the person who got you pregnant doesn't go through a lot of changes. Yes, they can have hormonal whatever pregnancy morning sicknesses here and there, but you your body changes, you start having stretch marks that you didn't have, hormonal little tennis ball boobs, they start going down. Like, and they, you get fit if you were not like me. And then on top of that, don't like the food that you used to enjoy. Now you have crazy cravings and you're always crying, always moody, always wanted to be, at least for me, I wanted to be with that man 24/7, and it was very impossible, Jennifer, because we're not yet married. Because what do you mean you want to be with him 24/7? Ma'am, are you trying to fart and said what? You know? So it was very bad. It was very bad. I wanted to be with him. I was very clingy, very needy, very moody. I wanted a lot of things to eat, and I gained so much weight from being a size 30 to being a size 36. Pamela, what do you mean? Guys, I gained so much weight. And as it is, even after pregnancy, I'm still getting weird comments like, yo, you've gained weight so much. Like, I know. Keep it to yourself. Keep it moving. You know? Like, yeah. And like, the morning sickness, but not a lot. But I did. The only thing I struggled with most of the time was nausea, especially in the first and second trimester. Like, I suffered a lot of nausea. And also, what happened with me when I was pregnant is that I isolated myself a lot. I started having weird communications with my friends. I was very inconsistent with them. I was just always with my man. And my family, that was my life. And then, like, I didn't go to church as much, but I prayed. And like, I didn't lose contact with God. I'm not gonna lie. I prayed because I needed what? Spiritual strength. I was struggling mentally. I was. That thing took me through shambles. Don't look at me like that. Why are you looking at me like that? I have to speak English because some other people don't understand Zulu.
Bua language you creating. I like to know people who are
Okay,
coming.
guys, I understand that mentally, I was very challenged a lot. So I know I'm just saying a whole lot of everything, not a whole lot of nothing. But yeah, like also I want to make this video very authentic. Like I keep it look not formal, ne? And then another thing was what? Niki batla bua ka yona. Guys, pray during pregnancy. Pray. It took a lot of praying to sustain and maintain everything that was happening. Because to carry life within you, what? It can't mean that God made a mistake. God won't want to misuse his material. He won't want to just dish out his gifts because a baby is a blessing. He won't want to dish out his blessing for what? Nothing? He's not bored. So he was very intentional with giving me that life inside of me. And they're like, that is a whole lot of responsibility, okay? Because you have to watch what you eat. You have to watch what you drink. You have to dress a certain way. You have to be at different places at a certain time. You can't go to certain places. You can't be with certain people. You can't say anything to everyone. You have to protect this thing that is not yet born. Because if you say it to the wrong person, then you might just endanger this life within you. Do you understand? So, like, that thing forced me to grow up. And then, like, to be honest, like, I didn't want to have a baby girl. Because first, I was scared to raise another me. Because what do you mean? I'm gonna raise a girl and, like, she's gonna be like me and I have to raise that. I didn't want a girl. I don't want to lie. Initially, I just wanted a boy. I was scared to have to raise another me and do it different so that they don't get to go through the things I went through that I didn't like about me. You understand? So, like that, and also having to grow now with another person in your life. Especially if they are a girl. Do you understand? I don't know, guys. Like, I had that in my head. Like, I don't think I'm ready to raise a girl. And then, ta-da, went for Sona. Guess what? It was a girl. God said, you need this. He was very intentional, and he knew it was the right time for me to grow and heal some certain areas of my life while investing on this soul to become whatever God has intended her to become. Do you know? Or do you understand what I mean? So, like, for me, it's teaching me how to relate with God as a father, not as just God. This pregnancy. But we'll go deeper into that. I don't want to be too deep. Yeah. And then, like, what advice can I give to someone who's pregnant or who's thinking of falling pregnant? Guys, make sure that you are ready mentally to have a baby and be a mother, because it's a full-time responsibility. You can never get a break from that thing. The only time you get a break is if you go to work, come back, and still they are here waiting for you. When you're back, they are your responsibility, okay? You have to account for their existence. Whatever they need, it's on you, okay? So make sure that mentally you're ready to cater for them. Yes, you can never be fully ready, but make sure at least that's what you want at that time. Yes, we don't plan. Most of the time, we don't plan our firstborns. Most, especially if they're made out of wedlock, you don't plan them. But at least make sure that you're prepared and that you have good support. Because if you don't, then postpartum depression follows. And that you go to your regular checkups because pregnancy has complications. For me to know that it was time for me to deliver, I had a heartache. Guess what? I get to the hospital, they're like, you're staying in labor. I said, what? Do you understand? So you have to go through your regular checkups and, like, oh, have a praying team around you, because guys, this thing is very spiritual to bring life to the world. Do you think that the enemy would love that? He's obviously gonna fight it, because what do you mean we have another new enemy to the kingdom of darkness? Like, the devil will fight that. So make sure that you have a praying team, you have a praying support system around you. Like, especially if you're saved, girlies, don't go for those street mates, like those niggas that are street wise and, like, they don't have a relationship with God, they can't pray for you. They can't cover you with their blood. They can't fast and seek the face and the will of God regarding this whole experience. Sorry, run. Okay. Yeah. And, like, I want to thank my man. That man. I remember when I was about to give birth, the way I stressed that man. He held my hand. He said, baby, you are so difficult. But you know what? I love you so much. And I'm here to stay. And I'm not going anyway. Like, we'll make this work. Because 1 minute I'm crying, 1 minute I don't want him around, 1 minute I want him around, 1 minute one dinner, because why did you do this to me? 1 minute, oh my gosh, you're the love of my life. I'm so grateful to. I took that man through the most, okay? Like, coming to think of it, would I have survived being him or being in his shoes? I don't know. Maybe that's why he was the one in the shoes and I was the villain. But bless his heart, because you know what? He kept his word. He said, December 25th, he went down on his knees. He said, baby girl, my wife. Jensen, Bless his heart. And I remember the day before he proposed, I called my friend. I had dreamt of it. I called my friend Tika Tiki and Balas as well. I said, guys, am I paranoid? But like, I keep dreaming about this man proposing. And then Balasa said, don't think about it too much because if he doesn't do it, then you will be mad. And then Tiki said, no, you're not being paranoid. Maybe he will do it. And I said, I don't know what to think anymore. And I chilled. 25th, they came with the family for Christmas lunch in the evening. They said, baby gender reveal. I said, what? I was so confused. Jiggy G, he's on his knees. Honola 24 hours. Donna, by Kilo. That man went down on his knees for my sake. Because I'm saying a lot of things and give each other everywhere. But like, I'm not gonna make another video about pregnancy after this, unless if I'm featuring that man just so he can give you guys his side of the story and the whole pregnancy experience on his side. But for me, I don't think I want to say more than I've said already. Yeah, what do you want to say?
Done.
Your pregnancy.
Yeah, go ahead.
My
It's
brother
okay.
was so shocked, but we'll talk about it next time. But he was so shocked. Oh my God. Pregnancy, pregnancy, tete, alim, sibiti. And then
That drew me soon.
I missed him for like a good 3 days. Like I didn't have contact with him in the house for like 3 days. But he will tell you all about it when he's ready, because now he's acting fresh for it. Only God knows. But I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I'll post it in the morning. I'm shooting it at night. Bless your heart. Guys, I'm trying to make this as authentic as possible. I'm not trying to have camera flash light, because otherwise I'll never shoot content, okay? I'm trying to be as authentic as possible and shoot whenever I can. And also, yeah, maybe tomorrow, which is the 8th, oh no, the 5th of July, because I'll obviously be with my man. Maybe we'll shoot a video for you guys. But for now, this is what you're getting. I'm shooting this on the 4th of July in the evening at 3 minutes to 9 p.m. So yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and I hope you guys are like, I just wanted to be honest. Like, there's no need for me to make this fun or like funny, or I just needed to be out there and like tell you guys the truth.
I'll find out to the advice of Baba
Okay, guys, that is not biblical. Let's
What's up? What is it?
see you guys.
Hi.